IKEA is curious about mass-produced uniqueness and has teamed up with Dutch designer Piet Hein Eek to see if it's possible to achieve.
Oh, it's nice.
It's yellow.
Really nice.
That's the starting point of anything nice.
Some might think of him as the uncrowned king of scrapwood furniture. But the raw talent of Dutch designer Piet Hein Eek goes far beyond that. Piet Hein Eek has had a sustainable design philosophy ever since he made his first ever waste piece as a student at Design Academy in Eindhoven in the late 1980s. His first piece was a cupboard made entirely from salvaged floorboards and old planks. Now he wants uniqueness to be part of everyone's daily life. Together with IKEA, he has created INDUSTRIELL, a mass-produced collection that celebrates imperfection. The collection will premiere in 2018.
It's so nice to have you here, Piet. Welcome, Piet Hein Eek. Welcome. So tell me, what ideas did you guys want to explore with this collection?
Well, the intro is quite accurate.
Yeah,
so we're almost finished.
Yeah.
It's not really the uniqueness by itself because, or the imperfection perhaps, but I think we got the similar idea that it should be possible to produce mass-produce products which still feel individual, and at least have a feeling, you know, the mass production and the whole ethic development of last century, since we're making mass production, we can also make perfect mass production. And at a certain moment, everything is perfect, and then some people like things which are not perfect. So.
Yeah, but mass production and uniqueness may sound impossible for people. How do you achieve that?
Well, I had a very simple idea for a while to make the molds by hand. And usually
we do molds, you know, CNC milled, and everything is computerized for perfection,
yeah.
Because that's how you measure what's good quality, is perfection, and everything should be alike. So
yeah,
so to tweak that.
It's equally expensive, except for the first. So we make glass, which is the best example, mass-produced glass at Arc in France, press glass. And they have a huge machines. We have two because we need different ones. And each one is not perfect, not round. And a part of the machine they have to switch off because it determines whether or not the glass is round. And those are all shit in terms of the normal quality which they try to achieve. So I think it's really such a nice idea that you make millions of glasses which are really bad. You know, that's.
But I think also it's you know, the thing that people like with IKEA the most is actually our low prices. We achieve our low prices by being smart for mass production. So, but on the other hand, we see a tendency that more and more people want to have personal choices and to actually go for personalization in different things and to be able to have something which is unique. So if we could marry the two, that would be like the perfect marriage, to still keep the good properties of doing mass production, high quality, and everything that goes together with mass production, efficiency, and so on, but then tweak the process into spitting out different things. So that's what it's all about, actually. We tried it in glassware, we tried it in porcelain, and even textiles you were onto.
This is the best, actually.
That's good. We're going to show it off.
I didn't expect it, but Karen asked me to do textiles at a Shakar weave machine in Russia. And with Shakar machines, you can make flowers and everything you want. So I thought we make checks and stripes, but drawn by hand. So it's not checks and stripes at all. It's very badly drawn. It's very difficult to make a sheet like this by hand with equally sized stripes and checks. So it's actually, I didn't succeed. And that's what we used as the which was really difficult. And in the end, we ended up digitalizing it ourselves because each time we got it back and they made an interpretation. And we just said, you have to take it literally. So it took months and months, and then we did it ourselves. And if you actually look at the fabrics, it really gives a handmade feeling. Mm. But it's just a lousy drawing made by a very nice machine.
Great. So in your work, I know you're very conscious about the materials you use. Could you be that in this larger scale?
The scale was in so many aspects challenging or inspiring. Mm. For example, I was quite annoyed about the fact that it was only for one season, because I always say if you design something, it should take as long as possible. So for years, that's our philosophy. You know, we have designs. The one from my degree, 1989, is still in our collection. Still, we're making money with it, but we sell a few a week. And then, so I was annoyed. And then I thought, our best chair, we sold 5,000 in 10 years, and now we do 35,000 in one season. So the effort is much better. You know, the investment is much better at IKEA than in our case. But you have to understand those quantities all the time. On every aspect you think about, it's different from what we do. You know, we make 30.
Yeah, I know, that's incredible.
It's fun. Or one.
Yeah.
Most of the time it's one.
Yeah. So thank you so very much, Piet Hein Eek, for coming. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.